grace. As I said, God's grace is nothing but the manifestation of Jesus coming as the Son of God. So Jesus coming and taking the wrath of this entire mankind, Jesus coming and taking the sin of this entire mankind is nothing but the manifestation of God's grace. We know the scripture, the gospel scripture, John 3:16. God demonstrated his love towards his people by giving his only begotten son. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only and only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. So Jesus is the manifestation of God's grace. So Jesus himself, we saw in the gospel account, I often speak, right? The four parts. The first part, understanding of sin. How did you understand the sin? Through the law. Right? So the second point in the gospel, what is the second point? Understanding the need of the Savior. So what did happen? Because the law came, through the law, you wanted, you needed the Savior. So the law is giving introduction to the Savior. The Savior is nothing but the Lord Jesus Christ, the manifestation of God's grace. Let us see the next scripture, Philippians 1:2. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. So from where are you getting the grace and peace? You are getting the grace and peace from both God the Father and our Lord Jesus Christ. So the grace of God is nothing but the Lord Jesus Christ. And next, Galatians 3:23-26. This explains, in fact, actually, if you want to further study, read the Galatians whole book, you will have a good understanding about the law and grace, and especially chapter 3 and chapter 5. Let me go to Galatians 3:23-26. Before the coming of this faith, we were held in custody under the law, locked up until the faith that was to come up, which is revealed. We already saw this. So until the faith came, what is the faith? The faith is nothing but the belief of the Lord Jesus Christ and his death and resurrection, and that he is the Son of God who took the sin of this entire mankind, is the belief. So that is nothing but the faith. So that is the faith which is through the manifestation of God's grace. And so the law was our guardian until Christ came, that we might be justified by faith. Now that the faith has come, we are no longer under the guardian. So in Christ Jesus, you are all the children of God through faith. How are we saved? We are saved by grace. We are saved by faith. Are we saved by the works of the law? Are we saved by the law? We clearly know, correct? We are only saved by God's grace. If we say we need to follow the law, then we are telling Jesus, your coming as a dual nature into this world is not sufficient. We still need to follow the Ten Commandments, and your grace is not sufficient for us. We are saying that God's grace is insufficient if we claim that we need to still follow the law. John 1:17 and 1:14. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and the only Son who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. Now, what is the grace here? I have been telling that Jesus is the manifestation of grace. Are you seeing it as part of the scripture? The Word became flesh. Which is this Word? The Word of God. The Word of God which became flesh is nothing but the Lord Jesus Christ. So verse 14 is telling, the Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. Means Jesus Christ dwelt among us. We have seen his glory. We have seen the glory of Jesus Christ. The glory of the one, the only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and full of truth. So this is the grace what we are speaking about. The entire grace is nothing but the Lord Jesus Christ. We only need Jesus Christ in our life. That is sufficient. We don't need any more law. The law was a guardian to us to point us to Christ. We don't need any more law. The moment we know Christ, the moment we are under the grace, the moment we know the sacrifice of Lord Jesus Christ, the moment we accept Him as Savior, the moment we accept Him as Son of God, the moment we accept His death and resurrection, the moment we believe that He is living God and equivalent to God, and He is a fully God, equivalent to Father as part of the Trinity, we do not need any more of the law. We only need grace. The grace is nothing but the Lord Jesus Christ in order for us to get the salvation. So if you go to verse 15, John testified concerning Him. He cried out saying, "This is the one I spoke about when I said, he who comes after me has surpassed me because he was before me." But the verse, out of His fullness, we all received the grace in place of the grace already given. So verse 16 also is telling, out of His fullness, we all received the grace in place of grace already given. So we are receiving the grace from our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the full deity of the Godhead. And verse 17 you see, for the law was given through Moses, grace and truth came through Christ Jesus. Right? Did we see how did the grace come? So the grace came from the Lord Jesus Christ. The grace of God is sufficient. The Lord Jesus Christ is sufficient for us in order for us to be saved. Romans 8:3. For what the law was powerless to do, because it was weakened by the flesh, God did by sending His Son in the likeness of the sinful flesh to be a sin offering, and so He condemned the sin in the flesh. So God Himself is telling, only given so that they know that they are living in the sin, so that they know that they were in the depravity and they lost the fellowship with God. So to make them conscious and the knowledge of sin, so that they need a Savior, otherwise they will go to hell. That is the reason the law was given, but not to redeem the mankind from the sin by the law. It is in the grace of God. Ephesians, we all know, I always tell, this is again one of the gospel scripture. Very wonderful actually, Ephesians 1 to 10 will tell the entire eternal plan is embedded in Christ Jesus. That is what verse 7 is also telling. Verse 8, for it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourself, it is the gift of God, not by the works, so that no one may boast. So you clearly see here also that you are not saved by the works of the law, you are not saved by the Ten Commandments, you are not saved by any good deeds or good works, but it is only by the grace of God. We saw that good works are the result of salvation. So now that you understood, the manifestation of grace is nothing but Lord Jesus Christ Himself. In Him, there is fullness of the grace. So if you commit any sin in your life today, what you need? The grace of God. Whom you need? Jesus Christ. So that is how, what you tend to do, daily repentance, small r, I often tell. You need daily repentance. You need to go to the Savior. You need to go to Lord Jesus Christ. God, I need your grace. God, I committed sin, I need your grace. Please forgive me. You always need the unmerited grace from Lord Jesus Christ. Now if you say, now do you think because you are committing less sin, you are going to go to heaven? No. If you count your sins, your good deeds will be less than the sins what you tend to commit in your day-to-day life. If you weigh your sins against your good deeds, they will be uncomparable. That is the reason you need the grace of God. the unmerited favor. You don't deserve it. You cannot earn it.